Welcome. I'll be reacting to Star Trek Discovery Season 3, Episode 2. Remember, this is not a market substitute. Please support the original on CBS All Access. Engage. Oh, we're gonna be on the Discovery! This reminds me of Star Trek 4 a bit. Oof. That's some good Star Trek acting there. Oh no, what if they start sinking? Now that was an opening. Dun dun!
Kayla?
Is she okay?
To find and fix all the blown EPS relays and conduits on the ship before we can go anywhere.
Oh, those crazy EPS relays.
Did I hear you say we still have no communications?
We are strangers. We cannot assume that we are welcome.
Yeah, let's get shields and weapons up first, then we'll worry about communications.
And I love you. And that was a new blocker to help with the pain, so you're welcome.
They're so cute.
If you stay in for a full cycle before doing anything else, I'll have Saru ground you.
Oh,
it's good to have you back.
Yes,
it's good
it
to
is.
Have you alive.
No, she's something's wrong with her.
I said you're good to go.
Did the AI download into whatever that is? Cause I'm getting some creepy vibes from her right now. If they find out that this ship has dilithium, those 50 life signs are gonna come after them.
We will not abandon what we believe. I am telling you what we will do in your absence. Ensign Tilly.
I would take her along, though.
You are dismissed.
Two slips of gold pressed latinum says she goes out on her own and ignores his command there.
Why are you talking to me as if we're working on this together?
Because that's exactly what
you are.
Absolutely not.
Follow you for the witty repartee.
Oh. Oh, I love her. Wait, these two are going? Well, this will end well.
But if it's not, then we would be walking into a trap.
This is like an RPG. Welcome, travelers. Do you have anything to trade?
Greetings. We mean no harm. Our ship crashed.
Starfleet ship. My name is Cal. Told you.
They can't help us, Cal.
Yes, they can.
We have dilithium.
The one thing you should never say.
Helpless is a shitty feeling, but it is not forever, and it doesn't make you any less capable. Do us both a favor and just admit that you're not bringing your A-game.
Paul, no! Listen to Jet.
I've never seen...
This is programmable matter.
Yeah, no, I know. That was a fix. You passed.
Okay, so this is reminding me of the sonic screwdriver device in Picard. So I'm wondering if the two storylines are going to connect at some point, or if this is just a natural evolution of that technology. I don't know. It's kind of cool. Although it might be a little bit OP.
I just always believed you would come. And you did.
Ah, here comes the old Western.
They're taking me to their ship.
No.
It wasn't a question, it was a statement. But you don't have up to date anything. High energy gamma and gravitational waves. You're time travelers.
Don't even think about it, Saru.
Lyta said Georgiou left Deck 8 to help out here. And you believe that? Georgiou. Help it. Seriously?
Give me my latinum.
Damn it! Paul!
Why is she letting him do that? I think she kind of likes it. Finally. Nice. Is there a way to warm the hull?
Jed, I told you to come see me if the pain got bad.
What are you doing, Paul? You're in a Jeffrey's tube. What?
Because I need you out of there alive so I can kill you.
It's
Paul.
Okay? Try to slow it all down if you can.
Thanks for nothing.
Back at you, Bobcat.
Bobcat?
I don't know. I'm on drugs.
I like my weapon.
We defeated control.
Oh, let her have it. Is that one of the apparating transporter things?
Sensors are showing hull strain in the lower decks.
System temperatures are exceeding nominal levels, Commander.
Commander, something is coming toward us.
Oh, they're gonna get a help. They've come to help. It's gonna be Michael.
Open a channel, Mr. Bryce. We will face whatever or whomever has come for us together.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Oh, I love her hair.
I landed here a year ago.
Well, it looks like those of you who guessed an All Discovery episode and then they run into Michael at the end were right. It was honestly pretty great finally seeing the rest of the crew again, especially some of my favorites like Jet, who seems to have a way bigger role, which I'm excited for. I love the really imaginative universe that they're starting to build, and the fact that Saru is determined to keep the Federation values. I think partly because of early seasons of Discovery. I mean, he had to deal with a mirror universe captain who was undermining what it means to be Starfleet coming out of the first season. He had an entire transformation of his very essence in the second season. I think that's made him the kind of captain who puts Starfleet ideals above everything else, even his own life. And that's exactly the sort of captain that we need in this future. Shout out to Richard, who pointed out that Gene Roddenberry had thought of this kind of a storyline where in the future the Federation was gone and they're trying to rebuild it, which became Andromeda, the show, sort of. And now we're finally getting to see that vision in the Star Trek universe. Honestly, I personally enjoyed episode one more, partly because of the combat scenes. This fight scene was a bit meh. However, this episode felt a lot more like Star Trek, partly with the crew all back together, the ensemble, being on the ship trying to fix it, classic Star Trek episode there. I do hope they'll give us some flashbacks about what Michael has been doing in the past year, partly for selfish reasons because I want to see more of Grudge, but also because I want to know what she's been up to rebuilding the Federation, because clearly she has this ship and there are a few Starfleet vessels still out there. So what has she been up to other than getting an amazing new hairstyle? I don't think the next episode will have a big conflict in it. I'm guessing they're mostly going to be regrouping and repairing the ship. Maybe they'll have a small little mission in there, but I don't think it'll be a big episode moving the plot forward. Comment below, what do you think is going to happen next?